Hey there, Super Anisi here with Dragon Quest II, also known as Dragon Warrior II here in America. For all I know, this intro right here was only in the American translation. Yeah, sure. Ah. Yeah, let's have it normal. Oh god, is this normal? It's kind of going slow. It's pretty much having a British version. This game takes place 100 years after the first game. Yeah. Oh. I have to say. Okay, so the game takes place 100 years after the first game, and the party members in this game are going to be descendants of, the hero from the first game. Let's see. There we go. There's like a portal here. This like whirlpool looking thing. And it leads us to the middle of nowhere, but it's gonna do us no good right now. So, I think there was like a point in time where I was thinking like, oh, this is my least favorite Dragon Quest game. But replaying the first one made me realize like how much of a slow bore the first game is. The thing about the second Dragon Quest game is that it does introduce party members to the series. Although in my personal opinion, it's a bit imbalanced. So I guess if I were to rank the Dragon Quest games, I'll say this is my second least favorite. This game was released on the Famicom, and Nintendo Entertainment System. Although you can play an updated version of this game on the Switch. It'll be a version based off of the mobile phone version. And I am, it's like, and I am actually also playing the Switch version as a bit of like practice. See, like, as an idea of where I'm going. I'm gonna have to like level up to like 3 first. I guess now that I'm at level 3, I'm gonna just go to the next location. I wonder if these slugs poison. I hope not. Ooh, jeez. Where's that next town? Oh, there it is. I could use an upgrade. There we go. When I was playing the Switch version, the guy in the corner, he was like, "Oh, you scared me. I almost peed myself." Something along those lines. Does not look like a mouse. Ooh, this guy looks like a toughie. In the Switch version, there was a guy here that sells weapons and armor, but he's not here. So the princess's name is Numar. So the thing is, you are the Prince of Middenhall, and the two party members are the Prince of Kanik and the Princess of Moonbrook. And their names are random. Looks like the prince in his name is Numar. So in the first Dragon Quest game, you can only save at the main castle. In the second game, you can save at any castle. Not just your home, but here in Kanik too. So whenever you come across a castle in your travels, talk to the royalty and you can save your game there. Thank you. I know that the medical herb is cheaper in the Switch version too. So the prince is supposedly in a cave to the east, I'm gonna say. Oh, they take more than one hit. Ah, it's the bowels that poison you. Oh, jeez, it's a good thing it didn't poison me. When did I get a lottery ticket? Huh. Search. I'm gonna say it doesn't look that big. Thank you. Yeah. So the prince went to Mildenhall. If I remember correctly, in the Switch version, that chest had an antidote herb. See, how do I check how much money I have? That doesn't help me. Oh, there we go, 250. Okay, so I'm gonna save here, and next time I'm gonna go to Mildenhall Castle and look for Prince. If there's anyone watching like the video, please subscribe, and have a nice day. Bye.